Hi everyone. In the previous lectures, we have covered the classification of signals, the basic standard types of signals, classification of systems also we have seen, even problems also, operations on signals like shifting, folding, addition, subtraction we have seen, as well as verifying whether the given system is linear or not, time invariant or not. In detail, we are going to study about system in fourth chapter. Later on coming chapters, in detail, we are going to see about the system, input-output operations and all those. So that is about your first unit as per your JNTOH syllabus. Whatever first unit topics are there, all those topics have been covered in our previous videos, lectures. Okay. So next I am going to start the concept of Fourier series concept. Okay. So last topic, in the orthogonality, while discussing orthogonality topic in the previous lectures, we have seen one topic like signal approximation using orthogonal functions. So the extension for that particular topic is Fourier series concept. Means whatever the given continuous signal is there, x of t, it is going to be represented as a series of components, Fourier components or harmonic components. So that the signal approximation using orthogonal functions is nothing but a Fourier series representation. So finding the constants and approximating it, the given signal in terms of its mutually orthogonal components is nothing but a Fourier series representation. So here why we are going for, and one more thing here, already introduction I have written, there are three important transformation for continuous time signal x of t. And those are, first one is Fourier series, second is Fourier transform. So in your second unit, the extension after Fourier series, we are going to study about Fourier transform. After Fourier transform, there is a Laplace transform. Remember, whenever we are going step by step, some disadvantage will be there with the Fourier series. That is the reason we are going for other transformation. Some disadvantage will be there with the Fourier transform. To overcome that, we are going for Laplace transform. Like that, advanced transforms are going to be defined. Okay. So now presently we are talking about Fourier series concept. So which is applicable to periodic signals only. This Fourier series is going to be defined, or we can find the Fourier series only for periodic signals. And one more point is also there. Not all periodic signals can be represented using Fourier series. Means whatever given periodic signal is there, it can be represented using its Fourier series, but not all periodic signals. Means some conditions must be satisfied by that particular periodic signals. Those conditions are known as Dirichlet's conditions. In detail, we are going to see what are those Dirichlet's conditions and all. So whatever conditions are there to be satisfied by the periodic signal, those conditions are known as Dirichlet's conditions. Okay. So in detail, we are going to see in these lectures later on, what are the conditions to be satisfied by a given periodic signal to represent it using its Fourier series components, and types of Fourier series, how many types of Fourier series representations are there, and types of symmetry. Based on symmetry concept also we have covered in previous lectures, even symmetry and odd symmetry. Just by seeing the signal itself, we can classify whether it is having even symmetry or odd symmetry. Means if the given signal is symmetric with respect to y-axis, we can say that it is having even symmetry. Suppose if the signal is anti-symmetric with respect to origin, then we can say that signal is having odd symmetry. So based on this even symmetry and odd symmetry also, it is easily we can calculate constants. In previous lectures, we have seen the constant representation as C1 or C12 like that. So whenever I am going to represent signal in terms of its Fourier component, some constants are going to be there like A0, A1, A2 and all those. So if a signal is having a particular type of symmetry, means it is easily we can calculate A0, A1 and A2. Some shortcut methods are there. Simplification is going to be further easy. Okay. So we are going to study about symmetry also. Okay. Types of Fourier series and all those. So this is the introduction to Fourier series concept.
Oh.
Next, coming to representation of Fourier series. So here I have mentioned, please read this, the representation of signals over a certain interval of time in terms of, certain interval of time means the duration is going to be given. One fundamental period we are going to consider. Signals over a certain interval of time in terms of the linear combination of orthogonal functions is called as Fourier series. Means the same thing, signal approximation using orthogonal functions. Okay. So the representation of a signal over certain interval of time using complete or closed set of mutually orthogonal functions is nothing but your Fourier series representation. So here this concept already we have seen, this kind of representation. X of t is approximated as a sum of linear component of mutually orthogonal functions. When I am saying linear combination means that mutually orthogonal functions are going to be multiplied with some constant and those are going to be added. That is a linear combination. Means this is a mutually orthogonal set. X1 of t, X2 of t, so on. N number of mutually orthogonal functions are there. So my assumption here is this set X1 of t to Xn of t is a closed or complete set of orthogonal functions. When we can say that this is closed or complete set of orthogonal functions, orthogonal condition has to be satisfied. What was the orthogonality condition? Already we have seen two signals are said to be orthogonal if they satisfy this condition. If their product over some interval of time, t1 to t2, product of these two signals over this integration limit is equal to 0. So here each and every function is orthogonal to other function. So this is a, my assumption is this is a closed or complete set of mutually orthogonal functions. So now my signal can be approximated as linear combination of these functions. So here this is a linear combination. Here c naught can be 0 also. Just I am taking one constant. After calculating we may get it as a 0 also. How to calculate also we are going to see. Now c naught, c1 multiplied with this orthogonal first function. Next c2 constant is multiplied with second function cn. So how many orthogonal functions are there? Those many constants are going to be there. Combination of all those, nothing but your signal approximation. So this can be familiar. Already we have seen these two representations, isn't it? Signal approximation. Now in the real examples for this mutually orthogonal function is trigonometric series or sinusoidal set. So first one, the best example for mutually orthogonal function is sinusoidal set. Sinusoidal set means it contains both sine terms as well as cos terms. So that is nothing but trigonometric set. So the trigonometric set, so infinite number of terms may be there or n number of terms may be there. Cos n omega naught t, cos n minus omega naught t, like that. So on, cos 2 omega naught t, cos omega naught t, 1. Next, sin omega naught t, sin 2 omega naught t, so on. So many infinite number of terms may be there. So this set is an example for closed or complete set of orthogonal functions. So any signal, now my x of t can be represented as a linear combination of these trigonometric functions. That is nothing but my trigonometric Fourier series. Next example for this mutually or closed to complete set of orthogonal function is exponential set. So here sinusoidal set is one example. Next example is exponential set, complex exponential set, because j variable is there. So 1 e power j 0 omega naught t means 1, e power j omega naught t, j 2 omega naught t, j 3 omega naught t, so on. N number of terms may be there or infinite terms may be there. So this is another example for closed or complete set of orthogonal function. So now my x of t can also be approximated as a linear combination of these exponential orthogonal functions. In that case, my as a signal approximation, my Fourier series is nothing but exponential Fourier series. So if I approximate x of t as a sum of linear combination of this trigonometric set, it is known as a trigonometric Fourier series. If my signal x of t is approximated as a linear combination of these complex exponential functions, then in that representation is known as complex exponential Fourier series. So here we are having total Fourier series, trigonometric Fourier series, basically two types. Exponential Fourier series, complex exponential or simply exponential Fourier series. So here one more long answer question we can expect. One important derivation is there, that is we have to prove that the sinusoidal set is an example for mutually orthogonal set. Means we have to verify this condition. X1 of t means I can take cos 2 omega naught t. X2 of t means I can take cos omega naught t. So each and every function in this is orthogonal to other. Then only we can say that it is a mutually orthogonal function. So the question can be like, prove that sin m omega naught t cos m omega naught t are orthogonal to each other where m is not equal to n. Or simply prove that sinusoidal set is an example for mutually orthogonal functions. In that case, we need to verify this condition. Similarly, here also e power j omega naught t into e power j 2 omega naught t over certain duration is going to be 0. If this condition is satisfied, then only we are going to call it as a mutually orthogonal functions. So based on which representation, whether we are representing x of t as a trigonometric set we are considering, we call it as a trigonometric Fourier series. If I am approximating my x of t as a mutually linear combination of this complex set, exponential set, means I call it as a complex exponential Fourier series. So this is about types of Fourier series. Okay.